This is the talk show that takes a no-holds-barred approach to politics, where truth and integrity are the standard and the Constitution honored. From Renaissance Studios, this is Champion News Talk Radio.
Good morning and welcome to another great edition of Champion News Talk Radio. We are brought to you by championnews.net, your choice for the conservative voice. This is Carol Parisi. Today, our founder, Jack Roser, and myself have our great friend and patriot and very, very knowledgeable on healthcare, Mr. C. Stephen Tucker. Good morning, Jack. Good morning, Stephen. How are you, Jack, this morning?
I'm outraged.
Uh-oh.
Yeah,
should be.
This fellow over here has ruined my lunchtime here. My stomach is turning in loops, and Immelman turns when this guy is a real expert, and he knows what's going on in Obama's medical mystery.
Nightmare.
Stirring up a lot of trouble. It's his big socialist scheme. Mm-hmm. And you've ruined my stomach is doing these Immelman turns.
Well, you can have a little more coffee and your breakfast will be okay this Sunday morning.
I can't simmer down. I'm a businessman too. And we have really good insurance for our people in all departments. So naturally, we'd have to be concerned about it. But Obama's thrown this whole thing into just, he is running by fiat.
That's right.
He's deciding what the bills mean and adding in his own interpretation of everything.
Mm-hmm.
But at this point, I'd just like to have him given Steve some kind of a funny endorsement here. he's in the business. He knows what's going on. He's articulate. Here's a man that knows a lot about the tragedy of Obama.
Well, Steve, thanks for joining us again today.
Thank you for having me.
Last time you've been on, there have been some changes in the health care law again. Yeah. Very interesting on some of the timing of these things. And I think our listeners would like to hear what these changes are and how it's going to impact them. So,
well, let's rewind back to 2010. Since the law passed, we have now had 13 parts of the law either repealed or delayed. The most recent one was the rate up on smokers. Since they are not allowed to underwrite any applicants coming in 2013 on 10-1 when the exchange is open, they can't do any underwriting, so it's guaranteed issue for everybody during open enrollment.
What is just real quick.
Underwriting would be
underwriting explanation for dummies.
Underwriting would be the process of avoiding adverse selection. An adverse selection is an insurance company insuring you without knowing all of the truth.
Okay.
So what they're going to do starting October 1st in these new open enrollment process, it's a national open enrollment process, people will be able to go into these exchanges and buy health insurance, but there will be no medical history requirements. So they could be in a wheelchair, they could have all sorts of medical diagnoses, they could be going through current treatment, they could be 8 months pregnant.
So pre-existing conditions are gone. And that's actually not a horrible thing.
It's not a horrible thing, but as I've mentioned many times in the show before, we already had state solutions for people with pre-existing conditions. Mm-hmm. The way the law was passed the same way that was passed in Massachusetts when Mitt Romney did his plan called MassCare, which we call by slang Romney Care.
Mm-hmm.
And what they did is they allowed people to wait until they were sick to buy health insurance. And you could buy it in the emergency room.
Can I wait until I get in a car accident to buy car insurance too now?
It's actuarially unfeasible.
Right.
But that's what they were doing. And what would happen very quickly afterward, within a year's time, the insurance companies were either exiting
sure.
the state of Massachusetts.
Sure. I mean, insurance is a gamble. On both ends.
Especially health insurance. Health insurance is about the assumption of future risk if and when it may occur,
mm-hmm.
not the assumption of all risk as it occurs.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And this is what we've done with Obamacare. So that passed in Massachusetts, and they had it repealed, this guaranteed issue thing where you can buy it whenever you want, because it drove health insurance premiums higher than they are anywhere else in the United States. Today, they're still the highest premiums in America, in Massachusetts. And so what they did is they decided to adopt ideas that were already working in other states. For instance, in the state of Ohio. In the state of Ohio, they have what's called an annual open enrollment period. And so every Ohio resident can apply for health insurance during either the month of February or March during a 30-day period,
mm-hmm.
where all health insurers in the state of Ohio open their books to everybody. So now, no matter how sick you are, you can get health insurance on a guaranteed issue basis. And each carrier is commanded.
But that's only in Ohio.
Only in Ohio. And it's a
30-day period. Because you can't go across state lines in the insurance.
Yes, we'll get into that. That's another thing that needs to be fixed. The repeal of the McCarran-Ferguson Act of 1945, that's got to go. We'll get into that. So a 30-day period where you can come in and buy. And the Department of Insurance says every carrier in Ohio, you must issue 4% of your block of business to sick people who can't qualify normally for your health insurance products. So they do that. So United Healthcare gives 4% of their block of business.
Right.
If they max out that 4% of block of business,
then they go to the next carrier.
Right. And they've never maxed out all carriers. And
everybody in Ohio, their fair share.
Right. And everybody in Ohio has health insurance guaranteed. So Massachusetts looked at states like that and said, we got to do something. We can't do this. Wait until you're sick and get a plan. So they adopted that option where you have once a year. Well, HHS in 2011 decided to do the same thing. And they rewrote Obamacare so that now you can no longer wait until you're sick and game the system. You can only do it during an open enrollment period once a year.
Hold the phone. They rewrote what Congress had passed?
Yes, they did.
Yeah.
Yes.
But they're rewriting.
This is a government bureau reporting to Obama, an executive group.
Oh, yeah. They become
legislative. And they changed the law?
Oh, yeah.
See, How do they do that?
The worst words in Obamacare are the secretary shall. It gives Kathleen Sebelius more power than the President of the United States. She can rewrite health care policy all by herself, issue edicts, which she's done. There are 20,000 pages of new regulations. They're coming all the time.
Where do they get the... That's against the Constitution.
Yes, it
is. To give her power like that.
Yes, but this administration doesn't follow the Constitution. They think it needs to be fundamentally transformed.
Right.
So they're doing it.
But what has happened new?
New. Okay.
And I think this is going to be very pertinent looking forward to 2014.
Yes. Just a couple weeks ago, they decided to suspend the employer mandate. So now all these companies that were scrambling to get themselves compliant with Obamacare by January 1st or face the $2,000 excise tax per employee from the 30th employee all the way on up, right? They don't have to comply any longer. They don't have to pay the mandate. They don't have to have Obamacare approved, very expensive insurance in place by 2014. And so when this rule passed, this new edict, right, from HHS, I always look at the HHS updates. They dump them out. And they always do it on a Friday night before a holiday,
mm-hmm.
right? So on the way to doing a radio interview in Georgia, I'm calling all my clients with over 50 employees. And I remember calling the first one, and I said, hey, I've got some good news for you. He said, I need good news. What is it? I said, President Obama just suspended the employer mandate. He goes, don't joke around. This is serious stuff. I go, I'm not joking around. They just suspended the employer mandate. Nothing till 2015. He goes, you've got to be kidding me.
Now, if he hadn't suspended it, what would have happened?
This gentleman, in particular, this particular client, was looking at about a $220,000 annual excise tax to the federal government for not buying and having in place by January 1st Obamacare-approved health insurance. So it's an excise tax, which means it's non-tax deductible. So he had to also figure $2,000 for every employee from the 30th on up, right? He had 128 employees, right? Full-timers. Now he's got to also figure out what his tax rate is, because you have to round that up to be equal to your current tax rate. So if you're at a 40% tax rate, that's really a $2,800 fine per person. So now all that pressure is off him, as it is for every employer with more than 50 employees, and now they can do what? Push everyone into the Obamacare exchanges. They'll have plenty of time to shop, look for their plan, see how much free money they're going to get from the few, the proud, the 51% of us who are funding this, the left paying taxes, and they're going to be paying for all of it.
Now, Steve, I have a question for you, though. 2014 is an election year again.
Indeed.
Do you think this was pushed off to push an agenda? If this came down before and the implications that it would be suffering, do you think they did this for political purposes?
I know. They did this for political purposes. See, the jobs report came out. And when the jobs report came out, they saw a massive intake of part-time workers.
Mm-hmm.
People around America were losing their full-time jobs.
Why were they losing their full-time jobs,
Why?
Steve?
Because those who are part-time, the employer is not obligated to provide them with any health insurance, and he's not excised a tax on those employees. So employers all over the country with 50 more employees were pushing them down to 29 and a half hours. Now the jobs report comes out and there's a massive intake of part-time workers. The Obama administration sees the jobs report. Shortly thereafter, we get that Friday dump, right? When everybody's on vacation over July 4th, that, yeah, we're going to suspend the employer mandate. My opinion is, I believe it will probably never be implemented because it is so onerous to America's small business owners that it's going to hurt them not just before the 2014 election, but if allowed to be implemented in 2015, it's going to hurt anybody who's still in office and any Democrats coming.
Well, so this would cut off this business of having people do a less than normal 40-hour week.
That's correct.
Because that was driving it. Now there is no necessity to move on that.
That is correct.
He doesn't have to make them all part-time workers.
That's correct.
So now what a horrible thing to do to people, to reduce, you know, broadly across the line.
But it's still hanging over their head because they say they're going to put it back up in 2015.
We're going to come back and we're going to hear more about the implications for you, your family, and Obamacare.